Alright, so we see that the code with a single bracket and a percent sign on either side is the logical code that we want to execute from within our HTML, like a for loop. The double brackets indicate the code that we want its results printed into the HTML document itself. Since from within HTML code, we cannot use indentations to mark the beginning and ending of statements and loops, we must use keywords like endFor and endIf to indicate the end of a loop or statement. Going back to my menu.html, I can see how I'm obtaining the result of a query and executing the output here in my HTML page. I will also need to substitute the code I had in my restaurant menu method, so that instead of returning a string, we will return a render template with the new menu.html file. Since I'm querying on my restaurant and menu items tables, I will pass my queries into the template so that my escape code has access to these variables. I will also need to import the render template function from my Flask library. By saving and refreshing the page, I see the same code with a few stylistic modifications I added inside my template. You'll be building your own templates very soon. I just want to talk about two more topics to help you get the most out of them first.